Okay, so we will start with our next topic, that is man-made disasters. Okay, so man-made disasters are also called as human-induced disasters or anthropogenic disasters, one and the same meaning. What is a disaster? As we have been seeing, I mean, reading about it from the first module, that is, disaster is a certain cataclysmic, that is something dangerous, okay, something that is going to cause damage, destroy, okay. So disaster is a certain cataclysmic event that seriously disrupts the functioning of society and causes human, material, and environmental and economic loss that exceeds the community or the society's ability to cope using its own resources. So, like I have told you in the previous first lecture also, wherever you will see the definition, you will see this line also that exceeds the community or society's ability to cope using its own resources. Okay, a small accident where you cope up by your own, you handle it by your own, doesn't mean a disaster. When disaster is to such an extent that it is damaging the life, property, and plus the person who is affected is not capable enough to deal with that disaster, it requires help from the external community, okay, to cope with the disaster, that is then called a disaster, actually. Okay. Then we have natural disasters that we have been seeing about it from the previous lectures and man-made disasters. So natural disaster is an event that is caused by a natural hazard, correct? And leads to human, material, economic, and environmental losses, which exceeds the ability of those affected to cope. And examples include floods, volcanic eruptions, earthquakes, tsunamis, and other geological processes, correct? So this about natural disasters we have gone through in the previous lectures. Okay, then man-made disaster is a serious disruption of normal life triggered by human-induced hazard causing environmental, economic, or life loss. Okay, damage caused is similar, and that is why we call it as a disaster, right? That is, it causes damage to the environment, people, economic, property, right? It's just that natural disaster is due to some geological processes, some climatic conditions, correct, which occurs naturally, and man-made disaster is triggered by human-induced hazard. Okay, people are responsible for it. Okay. Now, basically, man-made disasters are actually classified into nuclear disaster, chemical disaster, biological disaster, and technological disaster. Nuclear disaster, chemical disaster, biological disaster, and technological disaster, NCBT. Okay, so what is nuclear disaster? A nuclear and radiation accident is defined by International Atomic Energy Agency as an event that has led to significant consequences to people, the environment, or the facility. Now, when you look at the word nuclear disaster, so it is related to some nuclear radiations, atomic radiations, radioactive radiations. Okay, so because of that, the disaster which occurs is called nuclear disaster, like the Chernobyl accident. Okay, so the International Nuclear Event Scale, now classifying upon the seriousness of any nuclear disaster, the classification is from 0 to 7. Okay, 0 means nothing, 1 means anomaly, 2 incident, 3 means serious incident, 4 means accident with local consequences, 5 means accident with wider consequences, 6 means serious accident, and 7 means the major accident. Okay, so the nuclear event scale, okay, this shows the seriousness of that particular accident. Okay, if it is not that serious, we call it as incident, and we call it as accident when it is a very serious accident, that is from 4 level to 7 level. Okay, so whenever you read about any nuclear disaster and its scale is given, that this nuclear disaster was of this scale, so directly from that scale you can make out whether it was a major accident or whether it was a simple incident that has occurred. So what are the causes of these nuclear disasters? Basically, nuclear weapons are thus far more destructive and harmful to society than any other weapon. Many countries in the world have developed nuclear energy, right? the atomic radiation, the nuclear weapons. Okay, the developed countries reiterate, repeatedly say that nuclear energy will be used only for peaceful purposes. But we know it that nuclear weapons are the ones which are responsible for this nuclear disasters to a large extent. Then consequences that the radiation is released into the environment and people get hurt. Right? Nuclear radiation keeps on showing its effect for a considerable period of time, even after its explosion. Hiroshima and Nagasaki explosion, correct? You know about it. So it was all about the nuclear radiation. And the effect was a long time effect for a long period of time. And those who survive become mental and physically wrecked due to impact of nuclear radiation. Because of this nuclear radiation, the deaths are too much. And those who survive are some permanent, have some mental or physical disability. Two of the most famous nuclear accident occurred at the Three Mile Island Reactor 2. Three Mile Island is in the United States, where there was this failure of this reactor 2, where the atomic radiations were released. Right? And the Chernobyl Reactor 4 in the former Soviet Union. Okay, where from that reactor 4, the radiations were released and thus led to nuclear disaster. Then what are the mitigation measures? Mitigation measures in the sense what you can do to reduce the impact of the disaster. We should keep ourselves informed about the government plan and should act in accordance with official communication. Nuclear activity may affect our health and cause nausea and giddiness, etc. And for that, medical help should be available immediately. Okay, so that was nuclear disaster. Then next is biological disaster. Now, what is biological disaster? Biological disasters define the devastating effects that may be caused by an enormous spread of a certain kind of living organism that may be the spread of a disease, a virus, an epidemic, but also just a sudden growth of the population of a certain kind of plants or animals, for example, the Ebola and the swine flu. Okay, so whatever, now we are also going through a particular biological disaster, correct? COVID-19 pandemic, and that is because of the virus, correct? So that also comes under biological disaster. Okay, it is a man-made disaster, but it comes under the scope of biological disaster. Okay, so it's like similar examples, like you have swine flu, Ebola, okay, and other epidemics that are spread by some viruses and bacteria. So that comes under the biological disaster. So causes are that biological disaster spreads through the organism that is developed in the form of bacteria or microbes. Biological agents spread fast in the environment and then make an attack on the human beings. You just compare it with the scenario that we are going through from last 1.5 years. Okay, so biological agents spread fast in the environment and then makes an attack on the human beings. People inhale these microbes. When these microbes find themselves a host body, they start affecting the immune system of the body. Microbes also enter human body through open wounds or cuts. Okay, there are many epidemics and such type of pandemic which are spread by this biological organism, but because now from 1.5 years we are suffering from this pandemic of COVID-19, so you can easily relate the causes, the effects, the phenomena, okay, easily. Then consequences is that the attack of the microbes is generally slow, but once they are spread in the body, it becomes difficult to control them, correct? Sometimes it takes the life of the affected person. Many times it becomes difficult to diagnose the illness caused by these microbes and it proves to be fatal, that is death. Then what are the mitigation measures you can follow in order to reduce the impact of such type of disasters? So whenever we learn or hear about the danger of communicable diseases through official announcement on radio or TV, then we can take adequate and preventive and protective measures. So what now we are doing is taking preventive and protective measures only. Correct. We are taking vaccination, we are using masks, sanitizer, everything. So that are the mitigation measures only to deal with such communicable disease. We should quite often try to help in taking this type of noble cause and solve the problem of the affected people or try to create fund for this uncertain events. We have seen nuclear disaster, we have seen biological disaster. Next is the chemical disaster. Now, by their nature, chemical disaster may be defined as the manufacture, storage, and transport of chemical which may lead to accidents waiting to happen. Chemicals can be corrosive, toxic, and they may react often explosively. Okay, when do you say you know, these are the characteristics of the chemical disaster, that they are corrosive, they are toxic, they are reactive, they are explosive. Okay, so what are the causes by which chemical disaster can occur? Chemical weapons are the main cause of such disaster. Sometimes handling of hazardous chemicals in an irresponsible way can cause chemical disaster. Chemical disaster may also be caused by industrial accidents. Okay, so the impact of the chemical accident can be deadly for both human beings and environment. Correct? If there is any environment, chemical leakage. Okay, so then that is comes under the chemical disaster. Correct? Like Bhopal disaster. This is a chemical disaster because there was leakage of methyl isocyanate, which is a chemical, right? Which is the which is a gas, which is chemical. Correct. So that comes under the chemical disaster. So the impact of the chemical accident can be deadly for both human beings and environment. Chemical weapons are also weapons of mass destruction. Sometimes handling of hazardous chemical in an irresponsible way can cause mass destruction. Poisonous gases, like just I told you about the Bhopal gas tragedy, spread in the atmosphere, and the people who inhale the same air face dangerous consequences. Then what are the mitigation measures that can be followed? Now, chemical can be in the form of solid or liquid or gas. Correct. So, like we had seen the causes, when you don't, there is no proper handling, it might leak during transportation. There might be some chemical leakage or chemical weapons. Okay. So, what are the mitigation measures? Those industries which use the hazardous chemicals or produce such chemicals should have contingency action plan, an immediate action plan to help people if such disaster takes place. Now, basically, chemical industry, which is at a risk of a disaster, they should have a proper action plan if such disaster occurs. Such industries should have timely warning system so that people can immediately take safety measures, such as locking their houses and taking the family and animals away to a safe place. Then stringent safety measures and checkups in the factory and critical analysis of the working condition of the factory will help to take timely measures to check any disaster. Basically, we have been watching about this gas leakages, chemical gas leakage, which then if people inhale, they are going to get much affected and can lead to death as well. So wherever there is chemical industry, proper monitoring, proper surveying of that industry, timely action, everything has to be checked properly. Okay, so that the risk of such disaster can be reduced, because they are at risk. The chemical industry, the atomic energy plants, they are all at risk for such type of disasters, right? Then everyone knows about the Bhopal gas tragedy, where the gas leak, methyl isocyanate gas leak that has occurred on December 3rd, 1984. 8,000 people died and around 50,000 people were injured. Gas leak from a Union Carbide plant at night. Main effect, that is pulmonary edema, that is the heart disease, skin and eye damage. And secondary effect were bronchitis, bronchial pneumonia. People fled from the poison gas in the middle of the night. So the effect is too much to a large extent, the effect of such type of disaster. Then, technological disaster. Like you have such accidents, and now you have watching this picture of an aircraft. Correct? So, this is a technological disaster. Of course, no one is making this fire outbreak purposely, right? There is some technological problem in the working of the aircraft when such air crash or such accidents occur, right? So, Technological disaster is an event caused by a malfunction of a technological structure and or some human error in controlling or handling the technology. Either there is some malfunction in the technological structure or some human error in handling the technology. For example, you are driving and not you, I mean, I'm talking about wherever there are car accidents or something occurs. So it comes under the human-induced disaster, right? Either there is some technological failure or if you are not able to handle the tools, the driving tools properly on the road, okay? That is because of the human error. Even if there is a problem for malfunctioning the technological structure, so it is made by, it is man-made only. The whole technology is made by man. So if there is any malfunction in the technological structure, that also comes under man-made disaster, correct? So, for example, like we talk about derailment, okay? So derailment can be a technological failure in the train, or there might be some, design failure in the railway tracks, correct? So that is man-made induced. I mean, not purposely, we would say, a malfunction that is created unknowingly, knowingly by man, correct? So that comes under man-made disaster, okay? So effect of a disaster on families and individuals may be long-lasting and can endure for years. However, symptoms may appear gradually and impacts may not be seen immediately. All types of disasters are challenging, but technological disasters tend to be even more difficult because they are immediate, not a second. They are immediate, right? For example, in addition to the deep water horizon, BP oil spill, the oil spill that happened underground, underwater, deep water. Radiation leaks are another example of a technological disaster, as in the recent case of Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power station in Japan and the previous accident at Chernobyl and Three Mile Island. Now, of course, it comes under nuclear disaster because nuclear radiation, nuclear gas, nuclear radiation was responsible. But since there was some failure in the technology, how did the leakage occur? Because there was some failure in the technology which was not surveyed by people properly. So it comes under the technological disaster also. Similarly, when you talk about Bhopal gas tragedy, of course, it is a chemical disaster, but then no proper technology, for an accident to occur, maybe there was no proper surveying done, maybe there was ignorance from the people, okay, which led to this type of disaster. So that also comes under technological disaster. Fires or explosions, such as the Station Nightclub fire in Warwick, Rhode Island, that was caused by pyrotechnic malfunction, are also examples of technological disaster. Chemical spills from trucks or trains would also be considered technological disaster. Okay, now we already saw about chemical disaster, but chemical spills that is occurring from trucks and trains, okay, because of some technological malfunction or people not able to control the technology or use the technology, okay? So these examples will have different characteristics and effects on the environment and residents of the immediate disaster area. Now, technological disasters are stressful, especially because they are unpredictable. Correct, they are unpredictable. Individuals, families, and communities are affected. Some of the results include income loss, loss of job security, uncertainty about the future, family conflict, and stress. In particular, post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD, depression and anxiety symptoms were common responses to a disaster similar to Deepwater Horizon or BP oil spill, the Exxon Valdez oil spill. If you go through these oil spills, it was a huge disaster that has occurred. Okay. Impacts may persist over time for some individuals, while others show resilience earlier. It's not just the time of the disaster, but it's also the post-traumatic stress which people go through. Then, what can be the mitigation measures? What steps could be followed to reduce the impact? Maintain routine as much as possible. Reduce exposure to media covering the event. Stay healthy and find healthy ways to reduce stress, such as doing things outside, getting exercise, doing stress reduction exercises. Seek accurate sources of information to better understand the situation. Talk to someone you trust. Keep a positive perspective. You can get through this. Seek professional help if you are feeling depressed, anxious, or have trouble controlling your emotions. When you are part of such technological disaster, a lot of serious issues related to physical, mental health can occur, and therefore this mitigation measures to be followed. Okay, so this was few points related to man-made disasters. We will go through one more PPT related to man-made disaster. Just give me a second. Okay, like I have told you, man-made disaster is also called human-induced disaster or anthropogenic disaster, one and the same meaning. Okay, so a disastrous event caused directly and principally by one or more identifiable, deliberate or negligent human actions. Okay, it could be deliberate and it could be negligent also. Okay, human action. They are intentionally or unintentionally. Now, when you talk about explosions, so they are done deliberately. When you talk about purposely arson, arson is purposely when you are when some people are doing fire outbreak in a particular property. So purposely done. So that comes under deliberately, intentionally done. Correct? So all kinds of man-made disaster affect a person's mental, physical, and social well-being, of course. Mainly they affect the loss of life, damage to nation's economy, social disruptions, long-term damage and widespread effect. For example, nuclear explosion. Just we had seen that how long-term and widespread effect it has. Then, man-made disaster model given by some professor Barry Turner in 1978. He says that disasters arise from an interaction between the human and organizational arrangements of the socio-technical systems set up to manage complex and ill-structured risk problems. Technological disasters are usually associated with man-made infrastructure and are typically accidental. Consequences of natural disasters can be increased as a result of technological advances and human activities such as agriculture and forestry. Okay, so when the human activities have increased, the more and more usage of technology has increased, it also leads to consequences of natural disaster. Current interest is in safety culture. Whatever you do, whatever technology is developed, the safety culture has to be followed. Then, National Disaster Management Policy, which we will be going through in the next module. So they have given this, the meaning of this human-induced disaster. The National Disaster Management Policy, okay, of the country notes that rise in population, rapid urbanization and industrialization, development within high-risk zones, environmental degradation, and climate change aggravates the vulnerability to various kind of disaster. Correct? Because there is increase in population, increase in urbanization, industrialization, more development in high-risk, environmental changes, climatic changes. So all this is giving more, making the area more vulnerable to different types of disasters. Due to inadequate disaster preparedness, communities and animals are at increased risk from many kinds of human-induced hazards arising from accidents, maybe industrial, road, rail, river, sea, building collapse, fires, mine flooding, oil spill, chemical, biological, radiological, nuclear. We have just seen hazards rank very high in among the human-induced risk. Terrorist activities and secondary incidents add to this risk and call for adequate preparedness and planning. Correct? So when you talk about the human-induced disasters, basically due to the inadequate disaster preparedness. And that is why these subjects are introduced nowadays, so that people become more aware, people are more prepared in order to deal with the disaster. Okay, so inadequate disaster preparedness leads to such type of accidents or such type of disasters. Okay, so this is given by National Disaster Management Authority. Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India. So NDM, so all this we will see in the next module, that is the people responsible, like NDMPA's National Disaster Management Policy, that is made by National Disaster Management Authority, which comes under Ministry of Home Affairs, of course, which all comes under Government of India. Now we have a National Disaster Management Plan, and these are the nodal ministry or the department that is responsible for certain type of disaster, because there are a lot of disaster, right? And every disaster has different preventive, different precautionary measures, different mitigation measures, different steps to be taken, right? So every disaster is categorized under a department, so that that particular department is responsible to deal with that disaster. Okay, like when there is biological disaster, it is the Ministry of Health and Family Affairs. Chemical and Industrial, it is the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate, Forest and Climate Change. When there is civil aviation accident, it is the Ministry of Civil Aviation. In cyclone or tornado, Ministry of Earth Science. Tsunami, Ministry of Earth Science. Drought, hailstorm, cold wave and frost and pest attack, it is Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. Earthquake, that is Ministry of Earth Sciences. Flood, Ministry of Water Resources. Forest fire, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Landslide, the Ministry of Mines. Avalanche, Ministry of Defense. Nuclear and Radiological Emergencies, Department of Atomic Energy. Rail accidents, Ministry of Railways. Road accident, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. Urban floods, Ministry of Urban Development. So this is how certain type of disasters are categorized in under a particular department, so that that particular department will be responsible for it, responsible to deal with it. So what are the causes or reasons of man-made disaster? Ignorance. Of course, it is everything that is by people. Ignorance, carelessness, unawareness, illiteracy, strikes, human error, tourism, terrorism, vandalism. Vandalism in the sense purposely destroying some property, damaging to a property, weapons, water and sewage overflow, and chemicals. These are all the main causes and reasons of the man-made disaster. If you read here, our own fault, natural disasters for the most part can be avoided. But how much time and money do we spend cleaning up our own messes? It is the human induced, that is people who are responsible. These causes by people, reasons by people that are responsible for man-made disaster. How much time and how much money we are going to spend to clean our own mess? Following factors contribute to inevitability of man-made disaster. Inevitability in the sense it is bound to occur. Like we say, natural disasters are bound to occur because they occur naturally, they are not under our control. But now man-made disasters are also bound to occur. Why? What are the factors which make it, you know, compulsory? It is going to happen. Why? Because size and population and density of the city and overcrowding which is happening. Intensive utilization of rapid forms of mass transport. Poorly organized emergency services. Lack of warning to the people. Use of high technology sources of energy. Increasing pressure to mine fossil fuels. So all these factors make it, you know, mandatory that this man-made disaster are bound to occur. They're inevitable because all these factors are increasingly very high at a very high pace. General categorization of man-made disasters. Those in which disaster occur in circumscribed community. Circumscribed community in the small, that particular area only, and that affected to that particular community only. That is called the circumscribed community. For example, a landslide in the form of slurry occurred at the mining site during the rain that killed the workers and their family members who are present at that time. So that is called the circumscribed community. That is, people present over that particular site, they were affected. Okay. Then those in which victims of the disaster did not come from the circumscribed community. That is the other categorization of the disaster. In the sense, transportation disaster and oil rig fires. Now, when there are transportation disaster or oil rig, that is from where the extraction of the oil happens in the deep sea. Okay, so that also catches fire. Okay, so it has a lot of secondary effect also. That is, the scope of the effect is more. It is not just the community which was there at that particular disaster will be getting affected, but the scope of the effect will be too much to different communities as well. Correct. So that is called the oleric fire. That is called the disaster that did not come from the circumscribed community. Okay. Then, types of man-made disaster. Structural collapse, transportation accident, oil spill, arson that is purposely doing fire outbreak to a property, war, terrorism attack, deforestation and desertification, power outage, economic collapse, epidemic, fire accident, industrial accidents, and CBRN. CBRN, we have just seen chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear disaster. Oil spill. This is how an area where oil spill has occurred, it looks like. It is a human-induced disaster, correct? Naturally, there does not come oil on the surface. Okay, it is oil spill that is done by, that is not purposely done, but that happens because of the people, the navigation boats, the ships, because of which the oil spill happens. Arson, that is purposely you're setting the fire. Terrorist attack, so we know this. Deforestation, correct? See, between 1990 to 2015, the world lost about 129 million hectares of forest, that is around an area the size of South Africa. So much forest was lost. Structural collapse. Structural collapse are often caused by engineering failure, correct? Sudden, so that also comes under the man-made disaster. Sudden fall down or cave in of any type of structure due to various natural reasons, that is corrosion attack, flood, tsunami, tornado. Of course, corrosion attack, flood, tsunami, earthquake, everything, because of which the structure collapse happened. But if there is no proper designing of the structure, if your structure made is not earthquake resistant structure, or it is not made in order to deal with this high speed wind or the flood or tsunami, so that comes under the some engineering failure by man. So that comes under the man-made disaster. Okay, so it happens due to some natural reasons and also artificial reason, like terrorist attack, under design, arson, etc. So it's called the structure failure or collapse, such as building collapse, bridge collapse, dam failure, balcony collapse, etc. Some few pictures of bridge and balcony collapse. Building collapse are designed to support, buildings are designed to support certain loads without deforming excessively. The loads are the weights of the people and objects, correct? Causes of building collapse are bad design, faulty construction, foundation failure, extraordinary loads, unexpected failure mode, combination of all these causes that leads to building collapse. Effect and consequences of building collapse. The collapse of structures, including building, may result in death or serious injury to employees and the public. It may damage the adjacent structure. There is loss of property as well. What immediate action could be taken? Check for injuries and administer the first aid. Don't move seriously injured individuals. Communicate number and identity of missing people to emergency services, and don't enter the damaged and unstable building to search for missing people. So these are the effect, consequences, and immediate action when structural collapse happens. What are the prevention and the remedies that you can follow for a structural collapse, because this has become so common now, correct? So always hire a professional for building design and construction work. When building any high-rise structure, don't manage, use right amount and good quality of the material. Because when you talk about structure, it's not just a building. Is it dam failure? Is it bridge failure? Okay, any structure, any construction made when there is failure, and that we have been, watching about it or hearing about it in the news. It's not just the building, it's any bridge or any, just a balcony collapse or a bridge collapse or a dam failure. So that all comes under structural collapse. Understanding the reinforcement, foundation, and excellent structure won't sit on a faulty foundation. Use the right steel. There is a big difference between 8 mm, 10 mm, 12 mm, etc. The professionals know, the civil engineers will now know how important it is, the reinforcement and the different types of steel and the good quality of the material. Use the right concrete mix ratio when doing your reinforcement. Proper and particular mixer is needed. Mixer is different for a bungalow, flat, black cotton soil, sandy soil, pile and rough foundation, etc. That is all technically related to construction. When you are supposed to do any construction, not just building, like I said. So all these points need to be remembered. Understand the loads and weight. Poor structure design and building planning. Follow the books of structure collapse. Excessive alteration. Don't change the plan too much during the construction process. There is lack of adherence to specification by unqualified and unskilled person. Building collapse, few pictures. And transportation accidents, that is also man-made disaster, right? We have seen road accident, that is traffic collisions, are the leading cause of death, and road-based pollution creates a substantial health hazard, especially in major conurbations. Road networks are developed for better connectivity and service. Increased number of vehicles, violation of the traffic rules, speeding, drunken driving, poor maintenance of vehicle, this is all the factors for which people are responsible, correct? As well as of roads, as well as the improper design of the roads, are some of the main causes of road accident. So, few of the safety measures which we know it while traveling on the road, but many times people fail to follow it, and therefore such road accident, which is a man-made disaster, which occurs. Like simple safety measures, simple but effective but important, that is, look on either side of the road before crossing. Use a zebra crossing while crossing the road by foot. Wear helmet while riding a two-wheeler. Use seat belt provided in your car. Maintain a safety distance from the vehicle in front. Not jump lanes. The best way to be safe on road is to follow lane driving. While driving, avoid sudden acceleration and deceleration. Check the tire pressure, radiator, water, brake oil, and fuel frequently. Replace the worn tires and faulty headlamps. Dip your beam whenever you spot on the oncoming vehicle. In case of fire, try to get out as early as possible and do not worry about the baggage. Overcome impatience, anger, and intoxication during driving. So these are certain safety measures which we know it. We are aware of it, but sometimes we fail to follow it, and therefore we should repeatedly remind us, you know, during traveling on the road. Of the photos of road accidents. Then rail accidents. A railroad accident, that is disaster, is an occurrence associated with the operation of a passenger train which results in substantial loss of life. Usually accidents with freight, right, in the sense the goods carrying trains are not considered disaster unless they cause substantial loss of life and property. Okay, when do you call a particular incident as disaster? When there is loss of life and property. If there is an accident that occurs with the train carrying goods, and if there is not much of, I mean, loss of life, if there does not occur, which does not occur mostly in the goods train, and property loss is also not that substantial, so usually that are not considered disaster. The most common type of rail accident is derailment due to human error, sabotage, or natural landslide in a hilly track, or fire. Then it may be classified into mechanical failure, manual failure, civil work failure, correct? It can be further classified as head-on collision, with a collision or the accident happens head-on at the start itself, rear end at the end collision, derailment, driver's error, signal man's error, poor design and maintenance, obstruction on railway line, fires and explosion, fall from the train, civil engineering works failure, terrorism, suicidal attack, all these are the things in which the rail accident can be classified. And common causes of train accident are train or car that are defective, negligence by conductor, crossing that are unprotected, safety gates not in place, inadequate maintenance of track, sabotage, that is a terror attack, bad weather, particularly fog, failing mechanism, malfunctioning train signals or lights, and consequences and effects, you know, there is loss of human life, loss of property, inconvenience to commuters, loss of time, traffic has to be diverted, loss of reputation. And certain safety measures at this rail accident, that is at railway crossing, in order to avoid this rail accident, at railway crossings, pay attention to the signal and the swing barrier. Do not get underneath and try to get across. In case of unmanned crossing, get down from the vehicle and look at the either sides of the track before crossing the track. Not stop the train on a bridge or tunnel where evacuation is not possible. Correct? Do not carry inflammable material in a train. Do not lean out of a moving train. Do not smoke in the train and do not pull the emergency cord unnecessarily. So these are certain safety measures by which this accidents or the railroad disaster can be avoided. Two of the pictures of the rail accident. Then, similarly, you have aviation or air accident as well, like you had road and rail accident. So an aviation incident is an occurrence other than incident, other than an accident associated with the operation of an aircraft, which affects or could affect the safety of operations, passengers or pilot. Right? It is going to affect the operations, passengers, pilot. Air accident may occur due to technical problems. Now, what could be the factors? Technical problems, fire, poor landing and takeoff, weather conditions, hijacking, bombing, etc. So all these are the reasons for which this air accident can occur. Then similarly, you have sea travel accident where the ships can sink. Correct? Ships can capsize upside down. Okay, capsize in the sense upside down. Or crash in disaster. Perhaps the most infamous sinking was that of the Titanic, which hit an iceberg and sank, resulting in the worst maritime disaster in the history. Correct? So that was the sea travel accident we know. Similarly, you have space accident. Wherever you have, when you talk about travel, it can be road, rail, sea, spaceship, aircraft. So everywhere you hear about or has gone through the various disasters. So we need to know what are the causes and what could be done in order to avoid it. So space accident, that is, space travel presents significant hazards, mostly to the direct participant, correct? Space accident actually has effect on the people who are traveling to space, then those few people, then the other one. So astronauts, the direct participant, that is astronauts or cosmonauts, and the ground support personnel, but also carry the potential of a disaster to the public at large. Many times this space accident also has effect on the whole population as well, but direct effect is on the direct participants who are traveling into it. Accident can occur on the ground, correct? When you talk about space accident, it is not just in the space. It can occur during launching as well. So accident can occur on the ground during launching, preparation or in flight, due to equipment malfunction or the naturally hostile environment of the space itself. An additional risk is posed by unmanned low-orbiting satellite whose orbits eventually decay due to friction with the extremely thin atmosphere. If they are large enough, massive pieces traveling at great speed can fall to the Earth before burning up with the potential to do the damage at large scale. Okay? So this is all about the types of man-made disaster. Okay?